if you talk to yours.
Well, I can hear myself. Oh. Yeah. I sound exactly like you.
Yeah, I know.
Shit.
Have a holiday.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. I just stopped.
Like any other versions.
Can you hear me at all?
No.
You can't hear me at all?
No, well, you're sitting right next to me.
Okay, well.
not over my headphones.
Well, that's fine.
It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you. Somebody waits for you. Kiss her once for
good.
Me.
So this is episode 7 now, I think.
It is.
Because 6 was... 6 was the last one. And then there was some bonus ones.
Da-da!
6.
Riveting.
It's gotta be 7 now. So this is the Christmas special, or something. We have some other human being on this now for the first time, my own flesh and blood. I'm videoing this, by the way. That's on.
Well, I just lost all. I was gonna do the Lil Wayne thing. And I'm on camera, so it doesn't mean anything.
It's like we had a candle lit, but that didn't really go over. It was lit up here for like, not like.
It was lit. It was lit.
It was lit, fam. Not like that. It was physically lit for once. my brother is here, and you know, why don't you tell me a little bit about myself?
Well, Chad is my brother. Am I talking about myself? Or am I
yeah,
talking about you?
Yeah, you can talk about yourself.
Okay.
I didn't ask you to talk about myself, but...
No, I don't have to say anything about myself. I think it was all...
Yeah, all generalities. Like, you
know... There's podcast 6.5 where you lead into this.
Yeah.
Saying how great I am and... role model, all that fun stuff. So, so look out for that. And then this just speaks for itself. I am the guy he talked about in 6.5.
That's true.
So, I'm Erik. I am the oldest brother of 4
of the litter.
Of the litter, yes. Just had a birthday recently. Won't say how old I am,
Older than me.
Old enough.
And that, for what?
All kinds of stuff.
Oh, right. Look who's driving today.
I know. Well, not yet. Not yet. But yeah, work in restaurants. I've stayed pretty local. My whole life. SoCal kid, and I don't know. I'm just excited to get on to this little project that Chad's got going on right now.
It is, I don't know how long it's not, yeah, I think it's just going to be a project.
It's a project till it's not a project, probably.
Yeah, you know? Till it becomes work. Will I be bored of it when I'm, like, if I ever get paid for it? Is that when it becomes work and then it becomes, like,
No, isn't that the definition of like, you know, that's what you want to do. The second you know, you if you enjoy your job, you won't work a day in your life. Yeah. That kind of thing.
Who said that?
Anonymous. It's all those inspirational.
Sure. Yeah.
Anonymous is a hell of a guy.
What?
Girl.
Anonymous? Isn't that her name?
Yes.
Anonymous.
Anonymous. So Christmas, you get your shopping done? Anything like that?
Totally, dude.
Yeah, oh, me too. I'm done.
Donezo.
I'm done. Finished just now.
Oh, yeah. You had your phone.
Yeah, I did. Earlier.
On you.
Yeah, I just rushed.
On your way up here.
Shipping on that fidget cube.
This one?
Yeah.
This
no.
Fidget?
No, it's another one.
Oh, because this... Did you get a different color? Did you get lime green buttons on
yes,
your
I
fidget
did.
Cube?
Yeah.
Well, I wanted to ask you some questions just so Schozophronio, all the listener can get to know you. So I have four questions.
Four?
Because three yeah, right. is obvious and five is enough. So question number one, Erik, what is your favorite pet peeve?
My favorite pet peeve? Interesting way of wording that. favorite pet peeve, let's see. Because I'm a type A guy, just anybody who does anything slow. And I think I don't know if that's a product of me being the 2017, just growing up in the age that I am. Just anything slow, like the road rage on the sidewalk is a very real thing. You know, someone's walking slow.
Oh.
On the sidewalk, it's like, can you just? It's the fact that. Anything. You could be going to the grocery store in the transaction thing. They swipe their card first, but you know it's an insert. You're buying something. You're just in line. Yeah. You know what's happening next. It's that guy, and he's pulling out his debit card, and you're like, he's going to swipe first. I already know it, and he's going to be wrong. Yep. And there you go. I'm sorry, sir. It's actually an insert. Oh, sorry, you know, half of them are one thing, half of them the other. And that joke only goes so far because now, in fact, most places are now insert, and it's a chip card thing. And and so, you know, they insert, and then, you know, they hit cash back, and it's like, they didn't want it. And like, I'm sorry, I didn't want cash back.
I meant to you're already, cancel.
You're already, I'm already checked it. Like, that's the whole, they got rid of self-checkout with the bag thing, like when you know you have to have carry bags, and self-checkout with my friend, any non-human interaction that I can have, oh my god.
Yeah, there's grocery stores I avoid, or like, certain Targets don't have it, and I won't go to those.
No, exactly.
I'll drive an extra 10 minutes and go to a different store that has self-checkout.
Yeah.
Just so I don't have to talk to Lupita.
Yeah, it's like the human version of gas prices. I almost want an app that says like, oh, there's only two people in the store. I'm like, okay, I'll just go to, maybe I'll go to that one. Or maybe I want the busy one sometimes. So I'm not bugged. You're like, hi, sir. You like everything? You're looking for everything?
It's like when I went to BevMo today, I like walked in, and it's something that like is a part of my job that's like obnoxious. Where it's like, someone walks in, like, you need to, if you can greet them. Like, I walk in and, like, the lady at the register who's talking to someone says, like, how's it going? And I just kept walking. Like, unless that just happened to be exactly when I walked in and she's just saying, a woman over there is saying, how's it going? Loudly to someone that she's near. And that my whole... my whole BevMo situation was weird because I got my stuff. I got the reindeer games thing, and then I went up to the counter, and she's like, "Okay, well, do you have a BevMo card?" And I was like, not really. I mean, maybe you could try a couple numbers." So like, as I'm giving her my number, like the first number, I gave her my old cell phone number. She's like, full eye contact, and like smiling, and I'm like. 949. Not losing eye contact.
She's engaged. Like,
okay, blah blah blah. okay, this is weird enough. And then this was, I don't know how I feel about this part, but she's like, so what, you have any plans for the day? Like making small talk, which is bullshit. Any plans for the rest of the day? I was like, oh yeah, there's some people coming over to like decorate cookies and stuff. She's like, oh, you're making cookies? I was like, no, actually my mom's been slaving away. But as I say that, I realize like the guy working the next stall over
is Asian, yeah.
Yeah. Mm. And all those slaves during making the railroad.
But I guess you couldn't have like self checkout for alcohol. I wish you
could. Yeah. I mean, no, yeah.
Obviously too many problems, but yeah, I mean, I have to say.
So that's
yeah. My favorite pet peeve. Yeah,
your favorite one is.
Slow. Yeah, it's actually a mindset, and I have to like talk to myself and be like, all right, this is not, you know, not to put too much out there, but anything that you generally know what's gonna happen before it happens. It's you know, it's the guy with the blinker on. It's like, oh, he's going to try to merge in front of me. I already know it. And you know what? I'm just going to let him. Because I don't want to play that game where I'm watching him.
Totally.
And, you know, that's that kind of stuff where you're like, oh, God, just insert the damn card. You already know what it's going to ask you. Don't say cash back.
Even if it said no chip. Sometimes it says, like, no chip yet.
Right.
And they go like, oh, and you don't have the chip yet? It's still like, those types of people that are swiping first are bringing up, oh, you know, no chip yet, huh?
I was in that, the one Chevron that doesn't have a chip yet. Oh, whatever.
Yeah.
But yeah, I guess that'd have to be my favorite pet peeve.
That's my favorite one that I have. Yeah. I don't know if I'm going to answer these myself, but I don't think I've talked about it, so I'm just going to answer this myself.
No, you should.
My own shit, so this is what I'm doing. My favorite pet peeve is when the toilet paper is facing the cabinet, where so you have to like pull it under the roll.
It's the under roll. Now, being a well-traveled individual as myself, there's the cat thing that seems to be the number one defense against having the over. As opposed to the under on the toilet paper, because the cat will roll it.
Just like,
yeah, exactly. Yes, because you know, he's a wind-up cat.
Yeah.
And it just... So if they roll the toilet paper, if it's under, it won't hit the ground and
it'll just
cause
like
a mess and all that stuff. But there better be a cat in the house, because if there's not a cat in the house and it goes under, that's just laziness.
Yeah, that's...
It's just changing it for... just out of necessity, I guess. I don't know. It's just little things. There's a lot of little things like that. The toothpaste thing, like squeeze from the frickin'...
And that's what the pet peeve...
That's
what pet peeves are, I think, right? Mm-hmm. Like, just like little, like, oh, I love this.
Yeah, you have that little twitch. You look at something, you're like...
Yeah.
Like you start to twitch, and you're like, "Nah, that's."
Yeah.
I don't like that thing. It could be the smallest thing, but
a lot of things, like just dudes do in general, are like that, like wearing shirts that say "Dilly Dilly" on them.
Mm-hmm. It's the hot topic right now.
Curling the mustache. That whole like, it's just what.
Yeah.
Question two. I went on, I just typed in like 100 questions or like 20 questions to ask a guy. It was like an auto thing. It was like 20 questions and like to ask a guy.
So I was like, Cosmo.
I wrote down and it was like this blogger chick and it was like first date questions.
Oh.
So that's what you're getting.
First date questions? I'm getting first date questions.
Yeah. Next question. If you could pick one movie, and I just bundled it, and one song to watch or listen to Well, it's movie and song. So what movie can you only watch the rest of your life? And then what song are you going to pick to listen to the rest of your life?
Oh, man. That is a tough one. I wish it was TV show, because that's cut and dry.
Yeah, that's a little more... I guess that's a little more 2017.
Yeah. But in terms of... Boy, movie... God, I don't know. My favorite movie is The Godfather, but...
One?
Yes. I mean, two's not far behind, but...
I don't think I've sat down and watched that whole movie.
It's an amazing flick, and it's... But it's one of those that, like, if I'm... It's like desert... These are, like, almost desert island...
Pretty much.
...questions.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna... If I have that for the rest of my life and no other movie, it's not... That thing's not riddled with laughs.
Yeah.
It's, you know... It's
yeah, not, it does.
I'm not gallivanting through the meadow watching The Godfather.
Yeah, the nature of the question is like, yeah, you have to feel all types of emotions.
Yeah. The funniest line is, leave the gun, take the cannoli. Like, that's not really, it's a chuckle. Yeah. It's a hard chuckle at best. But, you know, you want something lighthearted if you're going to have it for the rest of your life.
That's true.
God, I don't know. That's too tough.
What about for, if you only had one movie to watch next year? That's pretty reasonable.
Oh, for the whole year?
Yeah. You only had one movie and a song. So when you're, like, just kicking it, and you want to watch a movie, it's the movie you're watching.
Gotcha.
And then, like, in your car, that's the song you're listening to.
Well, I mean, the song, I think the song would have to be... it's the most positive song that I know of, and I listen to it a lot, and it's Blue Sky by the Allman Brothers.
I was going to say, the Allman Brothers?
Yeah. Just dueling slide guitars, and it's mostly dueling slide guitars. It's super upbeat, and yeah, no, that's the song I would listen to. It's just, yeah, it's one of those I have in the background or whatever, but super... super positive song. It always keeps me in a good mood. You're gonna put it on up, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. You gotta crank it up though.
Oh, you were saying you wanted to get like a your, like, tattoo idea.
Oh, man, that inside, it's Eat a Peach. I think it's the deluxe one. If you open it up, the thing is, like...
Oh, like in the cover, and like
the cover. Yeah, the inside cover. Yeah, oh, my God. I don't know how many drugs you had to be on, all the drugs, to draw what they drew. And, yeah, as a sleeve kind of deal, yeah, no, absolutely. But that's multiple trips and multiple monies. But yeah, like movie wise, God, that's a good question. That's a good first date question, I guess.
Yeah.
But depending on how good, you know, how I felt about the girl, I would tailor the answer to,
that's true.
So, but, yeah,
and be like, she's all that.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, something like, you know,
or like obviously save the last day.
Like, hello, I mean, slam dunk, whatever, home run.
Yeah,
yeah. I don't know what movie. It would have to be some sort of comedy. Like, you know, like I keep going back to Dumb and Dumber because every scene is hilarious in that.
Yeah, that's
true.
Just,
it just really is. So, you know, it has to be something like that. I would have to go with that.
I think for me, it would be Death at a Funeral.
Ah, yeah. I just saw that.
The British one, not the.
No, there's only one version.
Yeah.
No, Death at a Funeral. If you haven't seen it, go see it, listener.
Yeah, the one.
Listener.
The one,
it's an order.
The one with the British one, the British people, not the, You know that band from the 70s, the British people?
Mm-hmm.
They did the YMCA song. And then song... I mean, we already played it. It's gotta be...
This is the song for the year.
The song of the year.
Song of the year. Burl Ives.
S-O-T-Y. This is my SOTY, bro.
It's the best time of the...
Song didn't stop.
Just cut it. Song don't stop.
Cut it.
Yeah, so... okay, and then these ones are... these ones are Christmas related because lest we forget. Mm-hmm. What is that? Is that a contraction? Is that like short for something?
No, it's just a word.
Lest we forget.
Yeah.
It's a Christmas episode. So.
A pardoning type deal. Yeah.
Lest. Yeah. What is the best present you've ever got for Christmas?
Ooh, best present I've ever gotten for Christmas.
And that might be like, I'll do a little, because, I mean, we live in a time where, like, if you were given money for Christmas, then, I'm saying this because it pertains to mine, if you were given money for Christmas and you spent the money on something.
Subcategory. So let me rephrase the question so my answer sounds better.
So you really got... What gift did you give yourself for Christmas?
I see. Yes.
What gift did you gift yourself after the
gift? No, I mean, I want to put some thought into that because it's, you know, presents are lesbianist.
Let's be honest.
Yeah, you know, it's how many gifts do you actually get for Christmas that you're like, yes.
That's true.
That's it. There's no Ralphie stories. Like, there's a reason that's a movie.
Yeah.
And it's because it's like, I wanted this thing for Christmas, and I got that thing for Christmas. It's you know, I'm not going to say it's rare.
Yeah.
And I, you know, people listening to this could be like, no, sorry, Erik, but that actually happened to me, so. And it might happen, by and large, that might happen.
Yeah, so
but most Christmases, Crimbuses.
Crimbus.
What? Most Crimbuses.
Most Crimbuses.
You know, Grimace.
Whack.
And the Tim and Erik thing.
Grimace.
Most Christmases are misses. You know, it's kind of, you know, not a miss, but it's like...
a miss in Christmas.
Yeah, you know, so what'd you get for Christmas is the inevitable question. And the inevitable answer is a lot of good things, you know, and your voice goes up and it's clearly you're lying to people and you're like, you know, a lot of good things. Like, you know, you know... Super nice shirt. I love the shirt. It's a button-up shirt. It's great.
The shirt that I'm wearing.
Yeah.
Because I'm seeing them today.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Or, yeah, this, I got a gift card for this gas station. Pretty nice.
Yeah.
Some gas in my car. I got what I needed this Christmas.
Yeah, it depends on, also, I guess I'm categorizing it in terms of, family gifts, I guess, quote unquote Santa gifts, as opposed to like friends will get you things and you know us, we exchange names, and those are the better gifts because it pertains to what I actually want. You know what I mean? There's a lot of guesswork involved as you get older from your parentals where it's like, I think he needs more socks.
It's more of like a safe.
Yeah.
There's like a safety thing.
Yeah.
There's a safety net of gifts, and you just grab out of the net.
Oh, yeah, cool.
He needs... You mentioned you almost ran out of gas that one time, so here's it.
Yeah, right, exactly.
You drive.
Yeah, you drive. Here's
you drive?
Yeah.
You know, here's some car wash.
Where are we, Southern California? Here's an In-N-Out card. And we're like, yes. Like, that will get you to Starbucks, inevitably, yes. But you know...
You hungry?
But...
You hungry?
Yeah.
Use my gift. I got you a gift. You don't say you're hungry when I got you the gift that I did.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't do that.
No. That $10 for In-N-Out, that should last you longer.
Than a trip.
Than how many times you say you're hungry.
$10. Yeah.
$10 for In-N-Out. That's what I get. Like, that's what I would eat in line for thinking about what I want to get from In-N-Out. Yeah. Yeah, $10 doesn't go a long way, I guess. You know, some for some people it's like, yeah. Get like a burger protein style. Okay, so yeah, that's like three trips. But for me, I'm like, okay, you wasted that.
For me, yeah, because he buys it for me, so $10 for me, yeah. I still have it. I haven't spent it. I haven't even gotten to spend it. Yeah, I go to In-N-Out all the time. I haven't even gotten to spend it, though.
Best gift.
Yeah.
What's your best gift?
I don't know if there'll be snow.
It was Burl. You're going to have... I have to excuse you. Burl. And when you
walk down the street, I paused it 10 minutes ago. Huh? Hi. my Game Boy Color that I got.
The Game Boy Color. Yes.
Remember getting it at Toys R Us. Game Boy Color and Bug's Life. One of the worst games released for that system.
Doesn't matter. It's the gift.
Yeah.
You know?
That was it. Yeah, that was it, I think. Besides, honestly, I love that watch. I mean, not that... The watch that you got me, like, a couple years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Just because I wear it all the time. And I get, like... I haven't gotten... That's the one thing that I get the most compliments on.
Really?
It's like, it's a cool watch. Yeah. And I, like... It's, like, cracked.
Oh, no.
Check it out. It's like, around 10 o'clock. Dropped it.
Unreal.
So.
Well, it's, you know, it's got panache now.
Yeah, I mean,
panache.
Panache? What is that? How do you spell that? Is it like panache?
Yeah, it's like panache. Panache.
Like panache?
Panache, oui.
Yeah, I think Game Boy Color with Bug's Life is the best gift. And then, yeah. Yeah. I think that's it. And then, yeah, okay, question 4. Favorite/least favorite Christmas song?
Favorite is,
just trying to sway here.
Burl. It's not Burl.
Burl.
Listen, Burl.
Burl.
Mm-hmm. Have that name. That's like Charles Barkley.
Burl. Burl.
It's terrible.
Burl.
It's terrible.
It's Burly.
It's
Burly there. Burly there underwear.
Favorite one? Oh, Tannenbaum or Oh, Christmas Tree in any way, shape, or form.
Really?
Oh, yes. Yeah, you know, the Vince Guaraldi one that inevitably you're going to pull up. It, right here. Is my favorite. It does... It, but, That's Christmas to me.
That's true. Oh, Tannenbaum, that is a good...
You know, like, we go through the trouble every year, pretty much. Most people out there will go get a Christmas tree. And, you know, it's just an ode to the Christmas tree.
Where are the Christmas trees?
And especially that one, especially. Just super mellow, and, yeah. That's my jam, at least for Christmas. Least favorite, and you can pull this up, and you already know it.
I don't want to pull it up.
Don't pull it up, because it's going to suggest, like, oh, you like this? Then you must like all other shit.
Oh, God, yeah. No.
Is Paul McCartney's bullshit song.
So many people, like, there is, like, the love and hate of that song is, I've never seen a song more black.
No, it sucks. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time in which he John Mayer's the song and says the chorus over and over and over and over.
Yeah, it's like
I don't need that in my life.
It's like a police song.
Yeah, it's police, it's John Mayer, just, what's the chorus? Alright, I'll say that 50 times and there you go, boom, hit song. I could also say best Christmas song, Last Christmas by Wham, worst Christmas song, Last Christmas by Taylor Swift.
That's funny.
Butcher a song and then nail a song using the same lyrics.
Did Wham make that song?
I don't know, actually. That's a good question. I mean, George Michael sings like he did.
George Michael sings like he did.
He gave some of his heart.
Like he died.
Last Christmas. He could feel it.
Yeah.
You'd feel it giving way of the heart.
Yeah. I read that open sentence with a...
He did?
He rapped that whisper. Imagine opening up...
Careless whisper. I mean, he rapped it.
That was a careful whisper. Around Christmas time, that's a careful... The gift is a careful whisper. That's gonna be
one. Brilliant. It's just brilliant. That ain't careless whisper.
Whoever broke his heart, whatever guy that was, who opened up
Minor Pigs.
If that was me opening up a gift and I heard,
how did that? Oh my god!
You know, after I get,
I better be sitting down.
Well, I was gonna say if I get up, I'm not
about 3D. I am pitching a tent.
I am gonna wait a couple minutes until that tent is dismantled.
Dismantled. No, sorry, that's Viagra commercial for me. It's like if it lasts over 4 hours, I'm consulting my doctor.
Now, after I hang up the phone from my doctor, and I just admit that I have a mast, full mast in my pants. I don't know where I'm going for that. I'm just saying, Merry Christmas. A whisper from
freaking.
That was my brother Erik, a little interview recording I got to do with him. I wanted it to be a full episode, however, with the continual growing pains of this podcast, unfortunately most of that recording is gone. I like went to listen to it again, like the whole thing after we recorded it, because we had to like stop recording and then bounce and go to get some pizza. And I went back home and listened to it, and most of the recording was like cutting in and out or just completely inaudible. Like there wasn't anything, which is such a bummer. But I want to thank Erik for coming on. It was a good time. I mean, it's always a good time to just hang with Erik anyway. He'll be on again for sure. Once I, you know, nail this down, I wish I could clone myself, you know, even though that'd be a little weird if you can clone yourself. Do you think if you can clone yourself, you would hang out with yourself? Like, you wouldn't have to say much, though, because you already know what the other person's thinking. That's probably not how clones work. I don't even know why I'm talking about clones. Why am I talking about clones? Attack of the Clones? Speaking of that, I saw Star Wars. Wow. Go see it. That's all I have to say. I'm not in the realm of spoiler. I don't play spoiler. And if you're someone who spoils things for people, don't be that way. You know? Just don't do that. But yeah, you know, Erik, thanks for coming on. You're the man. And what better way to end this episode than with a song from I'm not even gonna give it away. We're just gonna end it with one of the greatest songs ever recorded for the holidays. Merry Christmas, happy holidays from all of me here at Schozophronio. And have a good one.